As the Russian collusion delusion begins to collapse, certain segments of the media are straight losing their minds, while others are desperately trying to revise history and their part in perpetuating this entire hoax.
These guys are failing in their fundamental constitutional duty. I mean, is it going to take Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez to have to come and tweet something for them to get all worked up? Defend democracy.
This guy's idea of defending democracy is trying to undo a democratic election that he didn't like the results of. Right off the bat, this guy focuses all of his anger on the special counsel investigators, which is hilarious considering that just a few months ago, they said that attacks on Mueller were attacks on democracy. Funny enough, we saw the exact same reaction from Democrats and the media when Trump suggested that he might challenge election results if he lost. They claimed that if he did so, it would be an attack on our democracy, and yet what have they done since day one but challenge the election results? And for that matter, weren't the Democrats and the media calling for Comey's head back when he was investigating Hillary? Then Trump fires him and suddenly he becomes their new American hero.
The president ought to fire Comey immediately and he ought to initiate an investigation.
Can't just fire Comey.
Oh yes, he can.
It is clear that the motive for this firing was to stop an investigation that the president feared. History will conclude that this is the equivalent or worse than the Saturday night massacre by President Nixon.
Well, I was appalled by what Director Comey did. He owes not only Secretary Clinton, but the American people an explanation for what appears to be an appalling action.
President Trump called me and informed me he was firing Director Comey. I told the president, Mr. President, with all due respect, you are making a big mistake.
Now they're saying they don't even care what facts are in the Mueller report and that they're just going to continue to create their own facts that conform with the narrative. I think what's actually happening here is that the media is basically just being exposed for the frauds that they are, and so they have to play the victim to deflect from the fact that they're all just lying propagandists. Little Brian Stelter's actually out there doing damage control, telling people not to be fooled by the partisans.
The job of the nation's news media is to ask, to question all sides, to scrutinize all sides, to report on opposing points of view, and to only take the side of truth and decency. So don't be fooled by the partisans.
It's just like when it became undeniable that the Jussie Smollett case was a complete hoax, CNN and the others all pretended like they had nothing at all to do with the reporting. Now, of course, they're going to claim that they have nothing to do with the partisanship surrounding the Mueller report. Even Matt Taibbi, who's a left-wing journalist who hates Trump, has been roasting the media for promoting a story that they should have been very much more skeptical about from the start. In his article, he says, "There was never a real gray area here. Either Trump is a compromised foreign agent, or he isn't. If he isn't, then news outlets have once again swallowed a massive disinformation campaign, only this era is many orders of magnitude more stupid than any other in the recent past, including WMD. He continues, "Of course, there won't be any such reckoning. There never is. But there should be. We broke every written and unwritten rule in the pursuit of this story, starting with the prohibition on reporting things that we can't confirm." He continues, "Why would real security officials help litigate this grave matter through the media? Why were the world's most powerful investigative agencies acting like they were trying to move a stock, pushing a private, unverified report that even BuzzFeed could see had factual issues? It made no sense at the time, it makes less sense now." I know I went off on a little tangent there, so let's get back to that crazy MSNBC panel.
And you know what? We were attacked. That's one component of it. But the other things, the most corrupt administration in the history of the United States, we're going to find out because this nation is far better and worth the effort.
Yeah.
What corruption is he talking about exactly? If there was so much corruption, surely Trump would have been indicted by now. What about all the corruption that's been exposed in the FBI, the CIA, and the DOJ? Comey, Clapper, Brennan, all of them lied to investigators and none of them have been prosecuted. Clapper lied under oath about the NSA spying on Americans, Comey lied under oath about leaking to the press, and Brennan lied under oath about using the Steele dossier to get FISA warrants. Again, none of them were prosecuted and the media nor the Democrats have ever made any issue of any of these examples. What about Peter Strzok and Lisa Page? Both are now disgraced former FBI agents. What about Hillary Clinton's henchmen purposely destroying all their communication and data storage devices to get rid of evidence? No corruption there. It's pretty obvious that your faux concern over corruption is based solely on the political party involved.
It feels like the seeds of a cover-up are here. look, if I'm the Trump children and I'm having a party tonight, right? Like, they won the white privilege regatta, all right? Like, you cannot invest. There is not an African American person in this country that could have been investigated for 22 months, had their family investigated for 22 months, and come away scot free.
All right, Gay Don King, let's dial it back a little bit. Race has nothing to do with any of this, but leave it to the racists at MSNBC to shoehorn it into every topic. As far as I can tell, Trump and his family are being unfairly investigated for a conspiracy theory that was hatched as an insurance policy to Democrats losing the election. I really don't see how any of the hell that they've been put through could be considered privilege. I can think of at least one black man who managed to separate himself with every scandal that happened under his administration with the help of the media.
Committee. There are lots of other ways to get at the children. In this particular case, these grown adult children who were part of what appears to be the collusion or the conspiracy with Russia. Sorry, it is unlikely there's going to be anything in that Mueller report that's going to satisfy me in terms of why these people weren't even brought in under oath for questioning. Okay.
What in the hell is Gay Don King talking about? Donald Trump Jr. did testify under oath in front of the Senate. Look, nothing outside of confirmation of this conspiracy theory will ever satisfy any of these nut jobs. The reason that there's no indictments, the reason why there's no Russian collusion in the Mueller report is because there is in fact no Russian collusion. I think these people are literally going to have to be deprogrammed after almost 3 years of concerted propaganda. I think that what we can tell here is that the media will continue being a mouthpiece for the Democrat Party, they will never stop trying to destroy Trump, and there will never be a reckoning for the endless fake news stories coming out of the media. All we can really do is talk about it, share videos that expose the lies, and turn off the TV. And after you turn off your TV, head on over to Patreon, PayPal, or Subscribestar and consider investing into my channel. Since YouTube demonetized my channel, it's only thanks to my supporters that I'm able to keep creating content. Show YouTube that they can't silence us simply by taking away our revenue streams. Thanks to all of you, I really appreciate your support.